Are you one of those developers who learned some basics, but now you're stuck because you can't find any resources online to learn from? Or you follow some tutorial and you realize that the code is not scalable or future-proof and it is keeping you back? Or you went to a job interview and you were shocked when you realized how they do differently in a company than what you learned from tutorials, and normally you failed the interview. And now you are sitting at your house angry and you are searching on Google for more advanced content, but you can't find anything valuable, and that leads you to even more misinformation and bad practices. I was in the same situation as you are now, so please stay until the end of the video because I'm going to explain why most new tutorials are just bad. And no, I'm not gonna sell you any courses or anything like that. Hi, my name is Darko and I'm a Unity self-taught game developer. And I'm not a guy who worked at Rockstar on Red Dead Redemption 2 or at Ubisoft on Far Cry titles. I'm just a guy who has made a living in the game industry, and no, I'm not some sort of a millionaire or anything like that. I'm just a guy who has struggled a lot to learn programming on my own, and now I just want to share my experiences with you. Several years ago, I was a beginner just like everyone else, and I mostly learned from online tutorials. As a beginner, you don't know which tutorials are good, so everything that you find online looks good to you. It took me months to unlearn all the bad practices that I picked from these tutorials, so I'm going to list my concerns with current state of Unity tutorials and why they are so bad. Nobody is talking about this, but I have to say something about it. Most Unity content creators, especially those on YouTube, they don't build games at all. They are just full-time YouTubers. And this is the case with most content creators. They will talk about real estate or finance, but in reality, they got success through YouTube and not through what they preach. And this is the reason why there are so many tutorials out there that will teach you a very superficial way to code. Most of them will just study some random programming topic and they will make video about it, even though they don't fully understand it. Most of them have worked on a larger project where they had to deal with dependencies or where they had to build big systems, and now they are only teaching anti-patterns like singletons and similar. Did you know that setting all fields or methods access modifiers to public is wrong? Maybe this doesn't make sense to you now, but it can really hurt you in the future. Most tutorials will set everything to public and you're gonna think this is the right way. Also, using getComponent inside the update loop is very bad for your performance. Using GameObject.find can really destroy your game. You must cache your component references at a wake, otherwise if you do it every frame, you run a risk of your time complexity growing and that will result in a slower game. Not writing private before private field is wrong. How do you organize files inside your assets folder? Do you put everything inside a single folder? You must keep everything organized and tidy, otherwise you're gonna have bad time searching for things. Is your hierarchy a mess? If so, then you are doing it wrong. In those tutorials, they taught you the wrong way. This will really annoy me because most tutorials are just basic things, and if you look at popular YouTubers, they're just doing the same thing over and over. Nobody is creating tutorials on advanced topics. I don't know any good tutorials on editor scripting or tutorials on networking or advanced AI. And there are no good tutorials that cover the applicable use of interfaces. My aim is to make this channel about things that most channels don't cover. I will focus more on advanced topics, but also I will cover basic things so that you can understand advanced topics better. I will show you when to use interfaces and when to use delegate. Also, I'm going to show you how to create scalable on-demand object pooling, and I will show you how to create behavior tree AI that is used in AAA games. Also, if there are some topics that may interest you and that you can't find anywhere else, please leave a comment down below and let me know, and maybe I'm going to create a video about it. And this is it for today. This is my first video, so it would mean a lot to me if you like my video and subscribe to my channel. Also, if you want to be notified about my next video, click the bell icon. And see you guys in the next video.